Hello friends, in this module we are going to learn how we can create attributes and expressions in Lightning Aura components. So jumping into developer console, now I'm going to create one Lightning component. So I'm going to label it as LC demo one. So Lightning demo one component will be created. In a previous module, I already demoed you like what is the meaning of these things. So if you enable these checkboxes, so in that case, you will be able to use your Lightning component in tab, space, record pages, etc. So right now I'm just going to demonstrate attribute and expression, how you can use them in the component. So I don't need to place it in particular place. So I am leaving it as is. Clicking on submit. So here you can see two things are available. This is the description of this component. So you can close this. And in this component, you need to implement your code. So now I'm going to tell you like how we can create attributes. So we have two different things. One is attribute and one is expression. So attributes basically are known as variables in Aura components. So what you need to do, you need to write Aura colon attribute, then you need to provide name of the variable. So I'm labeling it as variable one. Then you need to provide the type. So providing a type as string, then you need to put the default value. So I am putting test value, right? So this way, in this component, we created one attribute. So attribute is similar to variable. Its name will be var1 and its type is string and default value is test value. So default value is optional. You can remove this part from this attribute. And if you want to provide value of this variable from somewhere else, so that is also possible. Now, how we can display value of this attribute on the UI. So for that, you need to create expression. So this is the simple plain text component attributes value. Now we need to frame one expression. So what we need to write, v dot var one. So this will be known as expression. So here v is representing the view of this component and dot var one is the variable. So I can save this. Now, if you want to test whether this v dot var one expression will display test value on UI or not. So for that, you need to create one application. So I am going to create one demo application. So I guess it is already there. So I'm going to search for demo application. Now here I'm going to use LC demo one. Saving this application, clicking on preview. Here you can see component attributes value. This message plain text is available and VAR is replaced with the default value that we set in the attribute. Right. So this way, if you create any attribute, so you can use this expression so that that variables or attributes value can be displayed on the UI. Right. So now if we suppose we have one more component, let me create one more component. So I am creating LC demo two and clicking on submit. So in Lightning component, or if you're implementing Lightning Aura component, so you can use one component into another, right? So this I already demoed you in previous modules. So from here, like this default value we are setting here. Now, if I go to this demo two, so here we can write C colon LC demo one. And from here, we can pass value to that variable 1. So inside these double quotes, we can pass the values, right? Now, so I am passing value from LC demo 2 and saving this. And here I am going to use C colon LC demo 2. So here you can see output is automatically refreshed. So here two outputs are available. So in this application, we called LC demo 1. So LC demo 1 will display value of this VAR attribute, and this VAR default value is test value. So that is displayed on the UI, right? Now we created one more component like LC demo 2. In LC demo 2, I'm calling LC demo 1 and I'm passing value of this VAR 1 variable, and value is value from LC demo 2. So this time in this LC demo 1, if this attribute is available, so its previous value will be overwritten and this value will be stored. And we are calling LC demo 2. So that's why this overwritten value is displayed on the UI. So if you have more than one components, so you can call one component into another and you can pass the values as well. Now, if I close this, if I remove this from here, and now I'm going to show you, like, if we don't have this default value, and if you want to set its value from the controller of this component. So in a previous module, in one of the module, I explained, like, we have these various files. So right now I'm going to click on this controller. So this controller is basically JavaScript file, and through this controller, we can also set value of the attributes. So here we need to create one handler. So let me first implement the code. So name of this handler will be init. Its value is equals to this. And action is c.doInit. Right, so let's understand this first. So this is basically a handler which will handle one event. So event will be init, like whenever this component will be loading. So this init event will be fired, and that init event will be handled by this handler. Value equals to this means, like, it is handled in this current component only. And action is, like, through which method you are handling that. So method name is doInit. Now, if this method is defined in the components controller, so here you need to use C dot, right? So V represents view and C represents controller. Now, I'm saving this code, moving here. So here, this my action is representing name of this method or function. So here I need to write doInit, then function, then these are the parameters, those I am leaving as is. Now, here, what I can do, I can set value of the attribute through this method. So for that, I need to write component.set. In component.set, we can set the value of that attribute, right? So now here, what we need to do, we need to use that variable or attribute in double quotes, and after comma separation, we can provide the value. So I'm writing demo value from components controller and saving this code, right? So when this component will be loaded, this init event will be fired and it will be handled through this doInit. Now we need to do one more modification, like v dot. So I already told you, whenever you are representing view, so you need to use v dot. And if you are representing controller, then you need to write c dot. So in this controller, we are using attribute of the view. So that's why we are writing v dot. And in this view, we are using the function of controller. That's why we are writing c dot. So this you need to remember, otherwise errors will be displayed. So moving here, doing a refresh. So here you can see the value which we provided from the controller is displayed here, right? So this way, I hope you understood how we can set value of attributes from the controller. So if you want to set the value, you need to use component.set. And if you want to get the value, then you need to use component.get. So now after understanding how we can set the value of this attribute from the controller, now let's create some more attributes. So I'm just, okay, let's keep it as is. So after this, I'm going to create one more attribute, naming it as new account, type equals to account. So here we are creating attribute for S object, and in new line, I am writing default. So here we need to set its default value. So in double quotes, I am writing S object type. Account, comma, name test ACC1. And after that, I'm closing the curly brace, double quotes, and this attribute, right? So this way, what we did, we created one attribute. Attribute's name is new account. Its type is account, and in default, we set the S object type, and then whatever fields that S object has, we are setting its values. Now, if you want to display its value, so you need to set, or you need to use an expression. In that expression, you will be using the attribute. So now I'm going to tell you how we can write that. So this is the like syntax of the expression. You need to use curly brace, then exclamation sign, then v dot. Now you need to use this name dot and name. So name of attribute is new account. And for this attribute, we provided default value for this name as test account one. So I'm sorry, it is closed mistakenly. So here, everything is saved. Now moving here. So LC demo one is called. Now clicking on preview. So here you can see it is showing test ACC1, right? So we provided value of this name as test ACC1. So that is displayed on the UI. So this way, if you want to use attribute for S object type, so you can set it like this. Later on in upcoming module, you will see like how we can set values into this S object type attribute dynamically. So we will be fetching data from like your objects, and those data will be available into these. So right now for demonstration purpose, I provided default values. But in later modules, you will learn a lot about these. Now, moving forward. So after implementation of this S object type attribute, now we need to create some more attributes of different types, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to, let me remove this. So I'm going to create one more attribute. This time name is array demo. So I'm going to create array of string type and providing default value. So moving it here in new line. And now here I'm going to put values as V1. So you need to use single quotes V1. Then again, single quotes V2. Again, single quotes. Then you need to write one more value as V3. So it depends on you, like how many values you want to put, because it is array, so it can store any number of elements. So name of this attribute is array demo, and its type is string. So it is having these values. Now, if you want to display it on UI, so array values, now I'm creating the expression. So V dot, then name of array, array demo, and then you can use indexing, right? So in this module, I'm not demonstrating any loop. So those I will be demonstrating in upcoming modules. So here I'm just trying to access the value which is available on the zeroth index. So I'm saving this, moving here, doing a refresh. So here you can see array values V1 is displayed. If you want to display one more value, so you can copy it, you can provide some space, and you can replace this 0 with 1. You can go here in the tab and you can refresh. So it will display V1, V2, right? And if you want to apply some formatting, so you can use HTML tags as well, like we used H1 in previous example, right? So this was array demo. Now, if you want to create a list, so that is also possible. So now I'm going to create some collections type of attributes for you. So I hope till now you understood, like whenever we want to create any variable, so we need to use aura colon attribute. Then every time we need to provide name so that we can uniquely identify that. So naming it as list demo type equals to list. So in Apex, basically we use collection as list, set, and map. So all those collections we can create in this Lightning component as well. And here I'm going to provide default values. So double quotes, then square brackets, and in single quotes, I can write values. So I'm writing list 1, list 2, list 3, right? So this way, all three list values are available. If you want to put more, so you can do that as well. And again, I am just providing default values. Later on, you will be like putting these values through some calculations also. So we won't be using all the default values. We can store the values in the code as well. Like we, in this demonstration, like we used controller and we set the v.var1 value from here. So through JavaScript controller also, you can control these attributes. Now here I'm going to write list values. So again, I need to create one expression. So v dot list demo, and let's say 1. And for separation between them, I'm using HR tag. So horizontal line will be available. So I save this code, moving here, doing a refresh. So you can see array values v1, v2 are displayed, then horizontal rule, then list values, list 2 is displayed, because I provided one here as index. So this way, whenever you want to create any attribute of list type, so that is possible. Now, if you want to create an attribute of type set, so that is also possible. So naming it as set demo, and its type will be set. And then you need to provide default value, right? So list can contain duplicate values, and set contains unique values. So similar to a list, you can create set as well. So let's say I'm copying these values, putting them here and modifying these. So here you can see set values, set 2 is displayed. So this way, if you want to use set, so that is also possible. Now, next I'm going to show you how you can use map. So map demo is the name of attribute. Type will be map. And here we need to provide default values as well. So double quotes, curly brace, then in map, if you know Apex, so you must know, like in map, we need to put two things for creating a pair. So we need to provide key and then value. So here I'm providing key as A, then colon, value as map one, then comma B colon map two, comma C colon map three, then closing it. So this way I created a map which is having these three values. So keys are ABC and values are map one, map two, and map three. Now I'm using this horizontal rule. Now here I'm writing map values. Map demo dot then key. So you can iterate over this map as well with the help of these keys, so that we will understand later on in the another modules. So now I'm going to refresh it. So you will see list, set, and map values are displayed here. So this way I created map. So I hope you understood how it is working. So whenever you want to create anything related to these collections, so you can simply create them. Now, if you want to like identify length of particular collection, so that is also possible. So suppose here I'm writing hr/length of list v dot list demo dot length. So here you can see it is showing length of list as 3. So this way, if you want to like find out size of particular attribute, so that is also possible. So now next, if you want to create JavaScript object, so we have one more type of attribute. So naming it as JS object, its type will be object, right? Now at top here, you can see Aura Handler is available, whose name is in it. Value is equals to this. So handler will be available in this component only. And here action for this handler is do init. So now what we need to do, we need to go to controller and we need to define this do init. So it is already defined in this controller. And instead of using this, we need to set the values for that JavaScript object that we created, right? So attribute name is JS object. So I will be storing values into this. Now, how we can do that? So first we need to create a variable. So I am naming it as data. Now we need to assign values into this. So inside curly braces, I'm assigning name, then colon, test name, then email, test@test.com, then semicolon, then component.set, v.js object, comma, data. So here in JavaScript, you created the data in JSON format and you assigned that data into the JS object. Now on the UI, if you want to display that, so first you need to save this controller. Now here you can use /hr/, and you can display that. So if you want to display JS object values, so you need to use v dot then JS object dot name and v dot JS object dot email, right? So this is the name of attribute. And through dot, we are accessing name and email. So those values will be rendered on the UI. So I clicked on refresh. So here you can see JS object values, test name, hyphen, test@test.com. So this way you can create JS object. You can set its values from the controller. And controller is working automatically because we implemented this handler, init handler. That's why it is working on load of the component, right? So this way, like we implemented lots of attributes. Now we need to implement one more scenario. So to understand that same scenario, like what we are going to do, we will be creating a wrapper class and we will be using that wrapper class in this Lightning component. So first of all, we need to create new Apex class. So naming it as LC demo wrapper. And inside this class, I'm writing public class wrapper test. And in this curly braces, you need to write aura enabled. Then public string my string one gets it, then again aura enabled, public integer my integer one gets it, and you can save it, right? So this way we created our wrapper class. So in wrapper class there are two variables, right? And now what we need to do, we need to like set values of this wrapper class, like my string one, my integer one in our component, right? So moving to a Lightning component, and here I'm creating one more attribute, naming it as user data, and type here I'm providing LC demo wrapper dot wrapper test, right? So here we created LC demo wrapper, and in LC demo wrapper we have this wrapper class, right? And wrapper test. So here it is having two variables that we can use. So I'm saving it. Now moving to controller. So here I'm writing component.set. Then v dot user data, then comma. So v dot user data is the attribute that we created, and it is of type this wrapper class and wrapper test, right? So in one wrapper class, like, you can have multiple blocks like this. So here v dot user data, then my string one, string value, my integer one, so here we need to provide integer value, right? So you can provide any integer value. So let's say I'm providing 20, 21. Then this curly brace is closed. And then I'm putting one bracket, removing this, saving this code, moving to our components view. Now, if I want to, render that user data on UI. So wrapper values v dot user data dot my string one, right? So now you might be thinking, like, what is the benefit of using this wrapper class? So benefit of wrapper class is, like, if you want to club values of different types, so you can create a collection in form of wrapper, and then you can use that all together. So here I'm using v dot user data dot my integer one, saving this code and going to refresh. So here you can see it is showing string value hyphen 2021. So this way, this wrapper values. So first of all, we created this wrapper class. And here you need to see, like, I use this @ Aura enabled annotation. So if you want to use these variables in Aura component, so you need to use this annotation. Otherwise, you won't be able to use these variables in the your Aura component. Then you can set values through this JavaScript controller. And whatever value you will be setting, you can use this user data attribute, because it's at, like, attributes name is user data. So here we can use it like this to display the values, right? So this way, I hope you understood all different type of attributes that I created to demonstrate you, like, how we can use attributes and expressions in Lightning Aura component.